I think everybody's going to be interested in what you said today. Like I said, I want to stay in touch with you. I'm not too far away from you either. We talked about that. And I'm willing to, you know, I know you need support. You actually could use money and support, but at least if not money, support from other people who can help you out. And fortunately, you have a few people. I just tell you, be cautious of all your new friends. You know, be cautious of be smart. That's all you.
I am smart, and thank you. That is very good advice.
Yeah, I just been through it with these cults and stuff before, and like I said, somebody actually came into my life and became my girlfriend, and it was all the cult, you know. It ran psyops on me, tried to make me insane, really, and I almost got there. So just, I mean, they're willing to go out to any lengths, you know. I live with my dad. Don't make enough money doing this. Get out of the house. Calling my dad, emailing my psychiatrist. You know, it was a really, really nasty experience. So just be cautious. Know that I know what you're going through. Regardless of whether you're telling the truth or not, you're making a difference. So people are going to come after you. And God bless you for, you know, I pray that you're protected in all of this, and that what you believe is true.
In the background, you're going to hear the Phoenix Enigma. He's a guy that I bumped into a video of his, and he was saying that he didn't see any traffic and blah, 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 blah. We've looked into some other shit, and it seems like the I-40 may have even been shut down, blah, 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 whatever. But this Enigma guy has Thomas Schoenberger on his freaking show yesterday. For one thing, Thomas doesn't go on your show unless you're controlled and scripted. For another thing, Thomas is the fucking piece of shit that sent me and my family death threats. Yeah.
I mean, I don't like what's going on, but it's none of my business. But see, he manipulates people. He tries to sick them on each other. That's all he does. He's a psychopath. He has a narcissistic disorder, and Donna Emerald plays into it. Because they're having this online, I don't know, cyber sex or something, and that's what she's into. So, but here he is continuing to just throw at me that he wants me to do this.
Appreciate what you're saying, but you have to understand something. I have spent the last at least 6 months, if not longer, trying to avoid Thomas, to avoid the cicadas, to avoid Q, to avoid Lestat, to avoid Duality, who is also Word, who does the post-production for all of Sophia Music, okay? In the process of me avoiding them and not saying Thomas's name on streams and avoiding conversations about this shit, I've been inundated with emails from Thomas directing me to scrub streams, scrub comments out of chats, and block people from the chats that didn't suit his narrative and didn't suit what he wanted. I refused. Since I refused, my personal life and reality has went to shit, okay? We are getting sued. My mortgage company's just abruptly gonna take our fucking house from us unless we come up with a buttload of money. There's a bunch of variables going on.
So don't you think, wait a minute though, so now you're telling me this, don't you think you should pull your fucking ass off YouTube, out of this fucking thing? Don't insert yourself. You're obviously heavily manipulated by this fucking clown.
You don't understand what I'm saying.
What are you going to do that's going to help yourself by making a YouTube video? What are you going to do by proving that Lestat and...
Let me make a point. I tried to pull myself away. This Thomas is Satan in my life, okay? I am at this brink where I either join teams with him, give him my PayPal, and let him put me on his payroll, or he's going to keep attacking me. Out of fear, I have kept Thomas's name out of my mouth, and I have held their secrets.
Why is okay? So now that we know this, all this stuff, why when Freddie invited you into the live stream and you talked to Lestat, everything was cool, and now it's an evolution of the story. You're telling me the story. You're cracking a smile. You're looking up. I'm like fucking, I'm just fucking in awe, man. I'm, you know, you're talking to China to Three. Auto LARP, I mean, their third-party fucking notification is in effect on all these motherfucking live streams, kid. So, I mean, you better fucking smarten up. Take a fucking break from YouTube. I don't want to see you touch anything that Lestat gives you, motherfucker. You are so played out.
You know what,
you are so played out, you need to fucking stop playing the game.
Anymore. I really don't.
You are played out, man.
I have nothing to prove to you.
You need to.
I don't even fucking know you outside of seeing a couple of your streams and shit. I value your opinion, and I've listened to you at great lengths.
Good.
And
I saved you.
Channel and all that
I saved you from
PizzaGate. Understand something.
I'm happy I saved you.
I'm 39 years old. I'm not a goddamn kid, and I'm going to do what the fuck I want.
Good.
So and if I feel like starting a live stream tomorrow, I will be on there whether you want to see me do it or not.
Good.
Checking out. Lestat put out three parts of his 10-part series or whatever. I was staying neutral as possible and giving you the benefit of the doubt. And that's why, I brought Thomas on, which you knew Thomas was coming on this morning because I immediately told you were on my stream when it happened. So, sorry. There's a lot of distractions in the chat. The thing is I now have to, I honestly feel in my gut that you are being extremely deceptive, Lestat. And so anybody that respects me and anybody that possibly has any, thinks that anything of my opinion, I want you to really take a couple of grains of salt with Lestat's videos. And I also like to say that since you decided to make yourself an opposing party to me just now, that I honestly have avoided watching many of your videos because I do not feel that you are, I feel like you're putting curses and you're using occult shit in your videos to brainwash people. And anybody that knows me personally, I've told them also, do not watch your videos. So just to put that out there, just on a personal note, that's how I really feel, Lestat.
Wow. I wrote Thomas back, and very interesting, I'll tell you this, because I've been exposing shit for a year. I exposed Q, I exposed Backyard Brawl, I exposed all these things. And it was really strange because this group that we've seen before, that information came out about lately, they've been acting really strange lately. But I'll say this, I'm very impressed with how Thomas wrote me, because he was very direct, to the point, no nonsense. So I wrote him back a very long email, just letting him know why I am at the point that I'm at right now, and how the reasons for why I'm at the point I am, and just anyway, all that good stuff. So I feel like it was a good communication. I haven't heard back yet. I may have, but I haven't looked. So, but I want to say this. I don't think it's strange for Thomas to email me, but I do think what's strange is all of this is coming to kind of a head. And I'm not saying, like, please take Thomas out of the equation, because you have all of those guys, Twitter, YouTube, in their Discord, just talking all kinds of shit and smack about me and leaving shit in my comments and just going kind of batshit crazy in the last 2 days. And what's
okay? Can you watch this?
We're looking. Explain what we're looking at. This is you talking to Thomas, actually, obviously.
Okay, so this is Thomas' email. This is really well known. And this is something, okay, when I read it, when the first time I read this, well, I was like angry, but that was just it. I never saw any evidence of this, just by what Thomas said. And he also said it face to face to me, that he saw the Fangle, Manuel Chavez, or whatever, doing that. Okay, so it says, when I caught him on his computer with what I looked like underage kids in underwear, he claimed that it was Mondograph stuff. Intel Balor, it's just someone that was...
Intel Balor. I think he's rebranded as Balor. I could be mistaken as of that, but he was around for quite a while doing research and whatnot. Fuck, that is my mic. Sorry, guys.
So it says no, it was child porn, and Manny was selling it and on back pages. Yes. And of course, I did ask him. I sent that reply to that email because someone was posting stuff about Defango on 4chan. And I thought, even at that moment, I thought possible that it was Thomas or just one of those.
Okay, just to make it clear again, STG is Thomas.
Yeah, he puts this because he tells people he's Saint Germain. Yeah, that was something that always like, what the fuck?
What's that now?
That he tells people that he's Saint Germain.
Oh, Saint Germain.
Okay. This is basically the whole email. Some of the information, I don't... to be honest, I hadn't opened this email since like 5 days ago when I first posted it. And it's an email between Tyrone. This is Francis Bacon, I think.
Yep.
Okay. Nathan, Duality of Man. This is the guy that's threatened me with the cartels and stuff in my video. And this is the guy that makes the Sophia music videos also. That doesn't make sense. He copy-pasted them from other creators. Okay? And this is something that I really don't know what the fuck... like, I was surprised. It's Tyrone Simpson of Francis Bacon and says, I'm tired of and heading to bed, but Nathan... Why don't you grow some balls and get Robert David Steele on your show? Okay, then you can see this picture that it's Masonic. It's just this from inside of a...
Yeah, it's obviously alive somewhere.
Uh-huh. I don't know actually if this is Francis Bacon at all, you know, but...
You, is that Bacon? You've seen enough pictures of Bacon, I'm sure. Is that Bacon, you?
But tell me, do I leave the image or?